ever since I could talk. Well, basically ever since I could walk. I go in a room by myself and play by myself. Like, I pretend I'm like I'm in a movie where it's me and other people and I play other people. I've always wanted to be on TV and I've always wanted to be on stage. And then when I heard about this school, it was like a really big experience for me. When I auditioned, I was really scared actually. And when I got in, I was so happy. And me, my mom, my dad, my sister, we had this big celebration. All of the family came over to congratulate me.
So this is the first day of the program. I picked up my son. He's excited. I'm excited. This is such a great program and an adventure for him. And I can't wait for the school year to start.
Today we just finished our final rounds of audition. So we did four rounds of audition where we pulled in children from all of the schools throughout Mount Vernon, including private schools, charter schools, and Catholic schools. And so we've created our first cohort of students, which will be officially the class of 2015, entering sixth graders and seventh graders.
So on Saturday, we had auditions and we brought in 17 new kids. Are any of those kids here today? Step into the circle, just step in for a second.
I am Evelyn Collins. I am the Director of Arts and Gifted and Talented for the Mount Vernon City School District. And because I have such a fabulous superintendent, Dr. Kenneth R. Hamilton, I was afforded the opportunity to make a dream come true. And that dream was to create a performing and visual arts school for talented students in the Mount Vernon City School District. And initially, I wanted to start with the ninth grade and just build a high school because that's where my vast experience is. But Dr. Hamilton and his wisdom said, let's start it with the sixth grade. So we started the program with sixth graders, and then we had some seventh graders. So now we have sixth and seventh graders. And then each year, we're going to build the program.
The level of expectation is set very high for the kids to come in and just achieve greatness. You know, you kind of got to have the trifecta. You got to have the material. Material's got to be right. You got to have the staff. You got to have the students. And I think we have all three of those.
How was band camp?
So the children are extremely excited. They've never done anything like this before. So their energy is You can touch it. You can feel it.
Magnet Bridge Program. Very happy that my son was able to come into this program. I feel very happy for Mount Vernon to be a part of this. And I'm wishing everybody luck this new brand new year. And yeah, wish Mount Vernon luck with this program. Perfect. Happy.
We started our Summer Bridge program, and that's the cool thing. And we're giving kids an opportunity to practice their craft for 3 weeks. We started August 3rd, and the program goes until the 21st, and it culminates in a showcase.
Hi, my name is Monica Celeste Johnson, and I'm the dance teacher for the Summer Arts Magnet Bridge program for our middle school students who will be attending the first performing arts school for middle school in some time in Mount Vernon. Can you believe it? The best part, I will say the second best part, and they're sort of equally, is that I have two assistants, Jahari and Kalila, and they were both in The Wiz, which I choreographed, so I had the opportunity to work with the smart, talented, quick, gifted children, young people, and they're in Mount Vernon High School.
Hi, my name is Kalila.
Hi, my name is Jahari White.
We're working at the Summer Bridge Program for the new performing arts school that's opening up.
Yeah, Dr. Collins asked us to come back and help her with the kids for the summer program because we were part of the cast for her most recent production, which is The Wiz. And so it was also an opportunity for us to get employment and also to further our skills and be able to give back to the community.
They had this when I was in middle school, because if I had this when I was in middle school, where I am now isn't where I should.
scholarships. If I had this when I was in middle school, I would be way up there.
Yeah, I personally feel like this is a beautiful thing. I'm really glad that Dr. Collins gave all of us the opportunity to share this with her. And I wish that, like she said, this was there when I was in middle school. But I wish I would have taken performing arts a little more seriously. I just kind of got into it now. I've been doing it for about a year, but it's become a part of me. So
I ended up writing a grant to the New York State Department of Education to support and grow the program. And I directed the WIS back in April. And so in directing the WIS, I came into contact with a group of fabulous high school students who were so committed, so dependable, and talented that I wrote them into the grant that they could be teaching assistants to all the teachers in the program. So as part of the Summer Bridge program, which is 3 weeks, my teaching artists, teaching assistants, which are my cast members from the WIS, they get to work with the younger kids. And so the kids are able to see the possibilities for themselves as they grow into their teen years, and then they have their professional teachers who are not only teachers, they're practicing artists.
Hi, my name is Tanisha, and I want to be a performing arts because I think it can help me with my singing and realize who I really am. I want to be successful, and I want to pass my gift on to other people.
This program means a lot to me because it can help me advance my singing, and I want to have
program because I think this is something I want to do for the rest of my life. I think I want to carry this and use this for the rest of the years that I do this and possibly go to college for this, to a performing arts school. And I think this is a good opportunity for younger kids that can't actually do this, like go to Juilliard or something like that, something small and make it to something big.
I've been singing and also acting for so long. Because that's what I love to do. Since I was a little child, I loved singing, and I always wanted to act in front of my mom, or do plays. It's really fun.
So the objective is we start off small as a program, and then we start to build and adding a different grade each year until we are finally a full school with grades 6 through 12. And we want to make sure that we create a healthy balance between the arts and between the academics, because we know without the academics, the arts won't take us anywhere. So, but with the arts, I'm so excited because we get to concentrate and give them some specialized training in the arts. In the academics, we're doing the rigorous program, the GMT type curriculum, and our objective is to ensure that all of our kids not only graduate from middle school and high school, but they get accepted into college and they graduate with honors.
The students are really fantastic, just across Mount Vernon. I've taught so many different places, and there is significant talent in the city of Mount Vernon, significant talent. And it's kind of hard for me to explain. A part of me kind of doesn't know where it comes from. But so many of the children here have these fantastic natural gifts, some things that they're just good at.
The summer program gives the students the opportunity to get to know their teachers, to get to know their discipline, and then also it's an opportunity for the children to get to know each other and to get a sense of what they're going to expect when they get to school in September. So it's actually a very exciting concept because hopefully the children will be that much further ahead. They will know each other, they will grow together as a group, and by the time September comes, then they'll hit the floor running, so to speak. We also want the children to get a sense of who they are. This program is about building self-esteem and creating artists.
Now and then, I get insecure. the truth is, it wasn't just that building. It was a whole area, a whole area. It was a burial ground. There might have been 15,000 bodies there four centuries ago.
But I think it's important for young people to know what's the history and their ancestry, because if they don't, they're gonna grow up not knowing what happened.
And not knowing what happens to what?
As in, like, their story of their ancestry. You don't know your culture. You heard of it, but you never really got it.
So how does not knowing your culture make you feel? What difference does that make? Who cares?
Like, when I don't know my culture, like, if my mom told me, like, I'm Jamaican, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't think, she just said I'm Jamaican, but she didn't, like, mention it. I feel like, okay, but I don't really know my culture, so how am I supposed to feel? If you go to an event and you don't know, you see everybody else doing stuff, but you don't know what you're doing. So you kind of feel out of place.
Thank you.
And so, taking them to the African burial ground will give them the opportunity to reconnect with, or maybe for the first time, for some of them, really learn about who they are and how we got here. And then, of course, we have the culminating performance piece that the children themselves will perform at the end. But for them to actually go to a Broadway show and to see Wicked, then they get to see the art at its finest.
Good evening, everyone. This is an extraordinary time to be in Mount Vernon. We have made a huge commitment to restoring the arts in Mount Vernon. We know that there are children in our community who are extremely gifted in the performing arts, and they may not necessarily be the youngsters who are demonstrating academic excellence, but are excelling in other ways. And we know that through the arts, we can capture youngsters that we sometimes allow to fall through the cracks. And this is an opportunity for us to do this.
It's phenomenal. I mean, the kids are doing a great job. I mean, for the short time that it's been going, they're doing an awesome job. You know, I commend, you know, the director of the program and her staff. They're doing a very, very great job.
Very good. The kids are very, very good. My daughter's in the Wiz. Her name is Monifa Parker. She was Dorothy.
Oh, first of all, our daughter is one of the students that was in the Wiz. So because of her being in the Wiz, she had an opportunity to work this summer and to teach dance, which is something that she loves. It's Kalila Hines. And she was one of the dancers that just came out on stage, and she'll be in the second act. So we're very proud of not only of her, but of her journey, and of the journey that when you get to some place to be able to do that, that you make sure you reach back and bring somebody else through. And that's what she's doing with these young children. She's very happy to be part of their lives, and it's nice to see that they continue to inspire each other. So we appreciate the opportunity.
More than impressed to see how the students have come in just 2.5 weeks. You know, I'm looking forward to seeing what happens at the end of the year, and this is something that our town has been starving for, you know, with so much talent that is being cultivated. When I see this, you wouldn't believe that this was the talent in our backyard. So, you know, I thank you guys for doing this, and, you know, I look forward to seeing other productions.
They're amazing, these kids. The talent that they have is just amazing. God bless you all. Good luck.
Shout out to my little bro, Tyler.
Oh, that's good.
Shout out to my little bro. And the kid over there in the drunk man killed it. Absolutely killed it.
Just want to say thank you to Ms. Collins and Dr. Hamilton for bringing the arts back to Mount Vernon. It's a wonderful program. If you're not at this show tonight, you're missing it. I encourage you to support the performing arts program. It's great. The students are well, and the staff is wonderful.
It was great. I love the show, and I love the Evil Queen. She rocks.
It was really wonderful. I'm glad I came. I went to Jamaica. My daughter called me and told me that I needed to come back. I bought a brand new ticket just to come back to be there, and I'm so glad I did.
The show was excellent. I really enjoyed it. Did you enjoy the show?
Yeah.
She enjoyed it too.
This is the best show. This is my fourth time seeing it. My daughter was in the play. She's the assistant director. Wonderful. I love the students.
Woo! My cousins go over here. My godsister goes here. They're great. The show was great. The drums was great. Love it.
Oh my God, it was absolutely wonderful. The kids in Mount Vernon have such wonderful talent.
So it's here. It's Mount Vernon City School District. And I feel very fortunate, but even more so, I think the parents and the students and the entire community are going to embrace this program because it's certainly overdue.